you see? You made out of plastic. America, plastica, you're not even democratic. Are we recording this shit?
I don't know why.
So, if you missed it, Modi was in Iran this week. I thought of belittling you of that pack of luggage that you didn't know, but the guy travels so much that he even gives pilots a complex. No, Captain Lalit, he's not as well traveled as that Gujju. Anyhow, Modi was in Iran and he signed a $1 billion deal for Port Chahabahar. And this is really important, although I'm murdering the name. Because if you take a look at the west of India, which side is west? I don't know. West of India, you either see a sea or a sea of religious zealots who can't handle the idea that we don't care about them anymore. Yes, I'm talking about you, Pakistan, you nincompoops. You see, for decades, Iran has looked to the east to tap into the energy needs of South Asia. Means us. One plan, a 1,700-mile gas pipeline from Pakistan, was even supposed to come to India. When I was a kid, I might add, helping all Iran, Pakistan, India, but it hasn't. Why? Well, genius, it's supposed to come to India from Pakistan. How can Pakistan allow that? Has India even let Pakistan win one World Cup match in 15 years? Not even one T20. So screw Iran and screw India. I forgot which side I am on. But in those years, the world hasn't remained still. And China has been bearing down on Asia, much to the dismay of the rest of the world. Because China, it is clear, you don't understand English. I don't think we understand you. But that didn't stop Pakistan from handing Port Chahabahar to China. And from there, China has been flooding its cheap goods to Afghanistan and Russia. Basically, China and Pakistan cooperate towards the West. But we're back. With this deal, we will not only double our energy intake, but build a port to supply goods to Russia and Afghanistan, who have been waiting them for so long. They've been like, please, please, give us some of your high quality product. I wanted a screwdriver and all I got was this purple thing. And when I complained about this, they handed me this pink unicorn. I don't want the pink unicorn. I want the screwdriver. A real one, not the pink thingy. A screwdriver. And what do Pakistanis have to say about all this? Well, who cares what Pakistan has to say anymore? You know, US killed an Al-Qaeda chief this week, right? It came as a great relief to Afghanistan where this asshole was operating. He was controlling all of Al-Qaeda. And Pakistan, well, Pakistan, condemned the drone strike. Really, Pakistan? Are you even trying anymore? And now China's blocking India's admission into the nuclear surprise group. In my opinion, China doesn't have a moral leg to stand on with its block on the internet and what's being called as the Great Firewall of China. But now, India hasn't signed the non-proliferation treaty. I will not allow this. We will fight to the death. Let me ask you, don't you see a pattern here? Every time India is going head to head against one country or the other, Pakistan tries to piggyback on the issue. So here's my advice to you, Pakistan. Grow up. Grow up or learn to hide it better. We do it too. Every time Australia is winning, we say, well done, Aussies, well done. You were a better team. But what we're really saying, and I quote my friend, Benchud, Madhashud, Kangaroo, Sale, ek catch me nahi chhodte. Pani piya koala ka bhoot, Sale chipki gaya ball se. And while Modi was away, the HRD minister Smriti Irani got in a Twitter spat with Congress member Priyanka Chaturvedi, which soon turned into a war. And these women had their nails out like, wow! They were clawing each other's faces, pulling hair. Metaphorically, of course, metaphorically. I think Priyanka Chaturvedi won the match after she body slammed Smriti Irani with repeatedly losing and yet becoming minister in the cabinet is your forte. You have a glorious day too, Smriti Irani. Yep, that was awesome. Promote her, Congress, promote her. Fuck Sanjay Dutt, Renuka Chaudhary did. So touchy, feely. And Abhishek Manu Singh likes blowjobs too. So, you got Priyanka Chaturvedi. She's bitchy, snarky, and sarky. I approve. Do you approve? Leave it in the comments. Subscribe button on the top. And like this video if you like it. I didn't say it for 1 week last week. And you buggers forgot that there is a thumbs up button there. Hit it! And guys, please go to our site and use the Amazon link if you're buying anything. Something, anything. It's a click for you. But for us, it literally means putting out this episode or not. Enough with the sappy shit. We did tech news. It's right here. And India is making supercomputers. Hopefully on our designs. Hopefully. Nationalists were battling NDTV last week. And Somalians were angry with Modi. Now they're angry with me. I'm Michal Lalit. Nobody loves me. Everybody. Even the Somalis. Damn it.